Hello and welcome back to the D-COT disCast. I'm your host Steve, and today is Monday, July 10th, 2023. And today we're talking about a new addition to the 2023 Food and Wine Festival. A fight breaks out at Magic Kingdom. Corn dogs are coming to Walt Disney World, and more. A repainted and refreshed friendship boat was spotted sitting in Epcot's parking lot last week. It's a completely different look than what we're used to. The entire boat is a navy blue with a yellow pinstripe. It's very bold, and I like it. Disney has been giving these boats a well-needed refresh over the years. The boardwalk at Disney World is getting a new kiosk, and it's taking over the old funnel cake kiosk. It's the Blue Ribbon Corn Dogs. You can find this kiosk at Downtown Disney at Disneyland, and they are now coming to Disney World. This is the current menu at the Downtown Disney location, which possibly might be the same menu that's going to be at Disney World, but there's no official word yet on that. So here's the menu. You can get classic dog, a pickle dog, a golden dragon, which is a classic all-beef corn dog crusted with panko breadcrumbs, served with a side of sriracha mayo, sweet Thai chili, and a mandarin. And a kid dog, which is a kid-sized all-beef corn dog served with a bag of chips. There's no opening date for this yet, but I know when I go to Disneyland Park, I always make it a point to get a corn dog. The one that's in Disneyland Park, I never got it from the Blue Ribbon Corn Dogs at Downtown Disney, but I'm sure it's delicious, and when they open, I'm probably going to have to make a special trip out there to check them out. At Epcot, refreshment port at Epcot is now closed for refurbishment until the Epcot International Food and Wine Festival 2023 begins. Speaking of which, Epcot's Flower and Garden Festival is now over, and it's time to gear up for the Food and Wine Festival, and guess who's joining? The Muppets! At the Epcot International Food and Wine Festival, the future of food is being made today with Muppet Labs. Join Dr. Bunsen Honeydew and Beaker as they experiment with tasty flavors at the Brewing Lab. Disney also announced on their blog some of the new merchandise that'll be available, and there will be more than 25 global marketplaces, including returning favorites such as the Fry Basket, yummy, Flavors from Fire, Canada, India, and Spain marketplaces. And get this, the full menu is out. That's right, if you're interested in finding out what kind of foods are going to be available during this magnificent festival, head on over to the Disney Food Blog because they have the entire menu for your enjoyment. The 2023 Food and Wine Festival runs from July 27th to November 18th, 2023. A few discasts back, I mentioned that Merida is leaving the Enchanted Garden at Magic Kingdom to make room for an Encanto meet. Well, good news is that the Merida meet and greet has relocated to Liberty Square, so they didn't get rid of it. Fantastic. The Enchanted Glade gazebo can be found behind Ye Olde Christmas Shop, and Merida meets at various times from 9 a.m. into the mid-afternoon. Yesterday, a fight broke out at Magic Kingdom. No, it wasn't because they moved Merida's meet and greet location. The fight took place in the walkway between Tomorrowland Speedway and Cosmic Rays Starlight Cafe. Nothing too serious, just a few punches were thrown. I mean, that is still serious, but not like the other fight that happened last month where the guy was all bloodied. So, I don't know what's wrong with people. You're in a happy place. You're in the most magical place on Earth. Answer the call. Don't punch him in the face. Today in Disney history, on July 10th, 2007, Disney College Program cast member Paul Scherer, who is a former U.S. soldier, was honored for saving the life of a four-year-old guest who had fallen into the marina at the Port Orleans Riverside in Florida. Vice President of Resort Operations and Transportation Kevin Myers presented Paul with a letter from Meg Crofton, president of the Walt Disney World Resort, commending him for his bravery. Well, that's it for today's D-COT Tizcast. We hope you had a magical weekend, and we hope that you have a great week ahead, and that your Monday is fantastic, and we look forward to bringing you more Disney news and reviews on Wednesday.
Thank you!
Today I'm going to leave you with a little polka polka as a request from NaskFan, one of our D-COT members and moderators. NaskFan, this one's for you. It's the Swiss Family Treehouse Swiska Polka. Enjoy!